calling on me at some point. And I'm thankful every time that I can step up and present. Being that this is a prayer breakfast, I thought it was only right that I would do a poem. that's not my father. Do a poem of prayer. And it is entitled My Prayer. So hopefully it blesses you all. Lord, keep my over-rationalization from blocking your deep revelation. Keep my need for only the explicable from blocking the sight of your marvelous miracles. Keep my lust for temporary pleasures from blocking the values of heavenly treasures. And keep these lingering double-minded thoughts from blocking my ascent to these mountaintops. Lord, keep the fear of sanctification from blocking the light of my illumination. Keep the pressure of my closest peers from blocking the morals that I hold dear. Keep all these sins and negative habits from blocking your teaching. That's paradigmatic. And keep the following of news and gossip from blocking your footsteps for me to be apostolic. Lord, keep the words that slip out in profane ways from blocking blessings so curses don't ricochet. Keep the internal reluctance I have to forgive from blocking your grace when I don't rightly live. Keep the fragments of a broken heart from blocking the line you've drawn saying restart. And keep the feelings of an empty soul from blocking your will for me to be whole. For without the help of an almighty Lord, I am just a man in discord, not fervently searching for a life with harmony, unaware of this chord, I live carnally, driven by my impulse or fleshly feeling and not how my true spirit is willing. As sheep wandering beyond the shepherd's reach, I'm protected from a devil who waits to breach any area I convey the sign weak to destroy me in a way that's not at all discreet. You see, he too would love to use me as an example. Another one of God's chosen, he easily trampled. But I was made to be a trampoline for Christ, causing others to leap in faith, elevate, and take flight. So my prayer to you, Father, is that you would remain my Savior, to strengthen me daily if ever I waver. So the faith which shields me as I embark keeps blocking the attacks of fiery darts. So the salvation that's placed on my head keeps blocking the spiritual traps the wicked spread. So the whole armor you supply keeps blocking the evil wiles the devil tried. And so the countless angels providing provision keeps blocking those demons who cause division. Right. Lord, so the doors you've closed in my life keeps blocking all the paths except the way that's right. So the hills where I set my eyes keeps blocking the valley where rivers of tears lie. So the strength given to do all things keeps blocking the limits previously seen. And so the renewed mind I transform keeps blocking the influence to conform. Lord, so the trust I have in your presence keeps blocking the things that are irreverent. So the word hidden within my heart keeps blocking the moral things the world would impart. So the peace passing all understanding keeps blocking the symptoms stress is demanding. Ultimately, so that my intense love for you keeps blocking the ability to be swayed by how others do. So that I might be seen as your child, whether standing in or out the crowd, whether under bright or stormy skies, whether life or death sink or rise, whether elements are in or out of my control, whether those I call friends come or go. My steadfast hope lies in you alone, for there is none other, and no one can clone the true and living God, the one I love, who the moon, sun, and stars sits above, watching my every move with precision, with an open ear always to listen, that any prayer might be heard if I just open my heart and speak the word. So to the Master, holding my life ever so delicately in his hand, this will forever be my prayer. In Jesus' name, amen.